Hello, welcome to the Bluff City Best Show. I'm your host, Samuel R. Bess, and I'm here today to bring some enlightening words to the people of the Bluff City. I have a good friend of mine who's come through today who wants to bring a word from on high. He's Minister Dennis Allen. Welcome to the show, Minister Allen. How you doing today, brother?
How you doing, brother?
I'm doing wonderful, man. I wanted to bring you on this show, man, because this platform is a platform that I want to use in a unique way to reach the people abroad, all over the mid-region and across the United States. Brother Allen, I've felt the call of God on my life to change up some things on this platform. And I just feel that for such a time as this, that God is calling for change on social media, and especially with me in this platform. So I want to ask you a few questions, just a few brief questions about yourself. Just give me a little brief synopsis on, let the people know a little bit about who you are.
Well, I'm Minister Dennis Allen out of Tunica, Mississippi. I've been ordained for about 5 years now. Prior to, I was in ministry, prison ministry, in my home church. And I went around and ministered the word of God in different prisons and correction facilities. Now God has called me to a different arena now. He wants me to share the word abroad.
Amen.
And I'm here to go wherever he leads me.
Amen.
You know, in the world of social media now, Jesus said that go into the highways and hedges and compel men to come in to my house, that my house may be full. See, now this is a form of out in the streets, mm-hmm. out in public. This is that type of form now.
Amen. And you know, man, I just want to let the people know, because I've been knowing you for quite some time. I just want them to hear a fresh word from the Lord and through you. So I'm going to turn this platform over to you and allow God to use you. And may the people of the Bluff City and abroad be blessed today. This is my brother, my friend, Minister Dennis Allen. God bless you all.
Receive. All right. Thank you. God bless you. I'm here to share the word of God. One more time, for this is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. God is so good to us. My sermon this morning is going to be, thank God for grace. My text, if you can walk with me through the text, Genesis 6:6-8. If you have your Bibles, you can walk with me if you will. But Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Can anybody say, I need grace? I'm sure you have been through some things in your life where God has shared his grace. Anybody know the word grace? Grace is unmerited favor. Grace. Can anybody help me say grace? Grace. Grace is something that you cannot obtain by merit. Your money can't give you grace. Your house can't give you grace. Huh? Your car, your creature comfort, your commodities cannot give you grace. Great grace is unmerited favor. My wife can't give me grace. I love her to death, but God is the only one can administer grace. Can anybody say grace? Grace is spontaneous. Grace is what we need in life. I'm sure you've been through some situation in your life. Maybe it's a sickness, maybe it's a disease, maybe it's the loss of a loved one. But God can administer that grace. He can help you through it. I guaranteed you that he'll help you if you trust in him. Right here in the book of Genesis, the 6th chapter, Noah was asked by God to build an ark. And because of the wickedness of man, I'm finna show you why grace was administered to man, to humankind. Watch this in the text. Genesis 6 and 5 said, walk with me if you will. And God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth. Do I need to read that again? And God saw that, I feel my help here. And God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth. But 5 said that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. I'll let that soak in. You can watch the news today. Can watch your community. You can look statewide, locally. I'm talking about all around the world. There's famine in the land, sickness, disease, murders, killings all over the world. I'm here to share the word today. Watch this. Watch verse 6 here. And it repented the Lord that he had made man. Can you imagine God saying, I wish I had never made Samuel. I wish I had never made Miss Tilton. Or I wish I had never made my mother, my son, my brother. It's right here. I feel my hip here stronger. And it repented the Lord that he had made man on the earth, and it grieved him at his heart. Verse 7 said, and the Lord said, I will destroy whom I have created from the face of the earth, and both man and beast and creeping things. And he said, it repented that I have made them. Watch this in the text. Noah in verse 8, he said, but there's a conjunction there. I feel tension in the text. Thank you, Lord. Right here said, but conjunction. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Can anybody say, thank you, Noah, for finding grace, because God was getting ready to destroy the world, was getting ready to destroy me. It wouldn't have been no me, it wouldn't have been you, if it hadn't been for Noah being a righteous and upright man in the earth back then. Thank God for grace, unmerited favor. I feel my help. Watch Ephesians 2 and 8. By grace are ye saved through faith, and not of yourself. It is the gift of God. Not of works, lest any man, any woman, any boy, girl, any man shall boast. I got to close it out here. I feel tension in the text. Thank you, Lord. Holy Spirit, guide me through the text here. Verse 7, chapter 7, 1 said, and the Lord said unto Noah, come thou and all thy house in the ark. How you asked to build an ark and bring all his wife and his children, because the land was so wicked back then. God was upset with man, because the imagination of his thoughts. It's in verse 5. Do I have to go back to it? It said it right here. He said, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. Let that soak in. Evil continually. Let me. Every thought of his heart, his mind, his spirit was evil. I feel my hip here. Thank you, Lord, for grace. Grace. Lord, have mercy. Thank you for grace. Right here in verse 12 said, it rained 40 days and 40 nights, and all the animals and all, just think about it. He had to get two animals, a male and a female. We go in an ark, they have no bathrooms. Huh? Two baboon, two lion, two dog, two cats, two leopards, two tigers, two pigs, huh? Two of every animal had to go into the ark, huh? We can't get along today in the same apartment, in the same house, in the same neighborhood. Animals got along. I didn't hear Noah say they had any fights or any disturbance, but I'm sure it was, but they still got along in that small place of livelihood. Hey, I'm getting ready to wrap it up here. I feel my help here. Thank you, Lord. Lord, have mercy. It's in the text. I thank God for Jesus. Yeah, I saw Jesus at the cross of Calvary. Yeah, anybody know he died? He bared the cross. That was grace he was carrying on his shoulder, because he saw my sins. He saw your brother's sins. He saw your mother's sins. He saw your granddaddy's sin. Oh, bless him the day he's gone. But thank God for my father. My mother's gone home. But thank God that Jesus, he went to the cross at Calvary. Anybody know he died? He carried the cross. Did y'all know they beat him? They slapped him. They slapped him around. They beat him till you couldn't recognize him. The blood gushed out of his side. Came blood and water. They put a crown of thorn on his head. He bare all our sickness and disease. Isaiah 53:5 said he was wounded, wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, but with his stripes, with his stripes, I feel my hip here. Yeah, Jesus. Oh. He bared the cross, y'all. There was blood. I saw blood coming from his forehead. I can sympathize with the Philippian soldier that sat there and witnessed everything at the cross. Matthew 27:54, y'all. Walk with me if you will. Yeah. Jesus was on the cross, y'all. They put nails in his hands. They put spikes in his feet. They put a crown of thorns on his head. A crown of thorns on his head. Yeah, they put a spear through his side. He died. Can anybody know? He died. He died. Yes, sir. He laid in a barber grave. He stayed there Friday, Saturday, I didn't sin, but Thomas said, he told Thomas that, blessed are those that have not seen yet believe. Thank you, Holy Ghost. I feel my help here. Thank you, Lord. Matthew 27:54, the Philippian soldier. The Philippian soldier was sitting there witnessing everything. The earthquake, when Jesus died, he put his head in the lock of his shoulder. I heard him say, Eli, Eli. Better die. My God, why have thou forsaken me? The Philippian soldier was down there looking at everything. He said, truly, this man, truly, this man was the Son of God. Truly, truly, this man was the Son of God. That's my witness. I didn't see him, but I believe. He told a woman, thank you, Holy Ghost. He said, only believe. It's the book Matthew. Only believe. Only believe. I believe. Yeah, I believe. Thank you, Jesus. I believe that he died early. Early Sunday morning. Anybody say Sunday morning? Early Sunday morning. I can't help it, y'all. Early Sunday morning. Early Sunday morning. He got up out of the grave. Let me testify. I feel my hip here. I went to the doctor. See, I get a regular checkup every year. And he said, I went into the doctor. I got a regular checkup. Doc told me, said, doing the examination, he said, brother, what you trying to do to yourself? I said, Doc, what you mean? I exercise regularly. I try to eat right. Huh? He said, your blood pressure is 175 over 115. I said, Doc, I feel good. He said, I see you. I said, I walked in. He said, but I can't let you go. You threatening a stroke. I know some folks. I thank God for his grace. I escaped a stroke. I escaped a stroke. Anybody said, I know some of y'all maybe escaped a heart attack. Huh? Maybe cancer was trying to eat your body. And God said, hold it. You healed in the name of Jesus. Yeah. I thank God for Jesus. Thank God for grace. Yeah, grace. Yeah. He's able to do anything but fail. Glory to God. I know he's able. Maybe your daughter was in college and she passed the bar exam. A lot of folks doubted her or doubted him. Maybe it was an exam that she took to be a doctor. Huh? Everybody doubted, but it was God's grace that kept her. Hallelujah. Gave her the knowledge and understanding to pass the exam. His grace. Hallelujah. His amazing grace. How sweet the sound. Hallelujah. That saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I know he's able. It was his blood that washed me. His blood washed me from my sin. 1 John 1-7. I'm finna go. He said 1-7. The blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanses us from all sin. Jesus. Glory to God. He's able. I got to go, y'all. But I feel my help here. The Lord. Lord, I asked God, I said, when I speak about grace, I said, Lord, what should you do with my sin? Hadn't always been saved. But what did you do with my sin? I heard him say, young man, Psalm 85:2 said, I have covered your sin. Psalm 103:10 said, he doesn't dealt with man after his sin. Psalm 103:12 said, as far as the east is from the west, that's how far he has cast my sins. Job 14:17, my sins he has sealed up in a bag and closed up the bag. Micah 7:19 said, you cast my sin in the depth of the sea. Hallelujah. Isaiah 38:17 said, thou hast cast all my sin. Hallelujah. In the depth of the sea. Hebrews 10:17 says, and their sin and iniquity I will remember no more. Hallelujah. It was grace that has kept me saved thus far. In the same grace that shall lead me on. Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus. Jesus, that name, I can't explain it, but it's something about that name, something, that name that holdeth the rain, that name heal all my sorrow, that name give sight to the blind, that name heal the sick, that name raise the dead, that name all power, all power. I got to go, y'all. I'm sorry, but I don't mean act that way, but something about that name, Jesus. Hallelujah. It give me power. Hallelujah. Give me a will to go on. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus. I'm sorry. I got to go. Thank God for his grace. Thank you, Brother Bess, for the opportunity. Glory to God. But he's been good to me. I can't hold my peace. Maybe somebody lost a loved one that's under the sound of my voice. Maybe it's your mother. Maybe it's your father. Maybe it's your son that's been shot, killed. But I don't know, but his grace. Grace. He's able, y'all. I'm sorry I didn't mean to act that way, but it's just the Holy Ghost that come over me at times, and I can't hold my peace. That's why I asked the Lord. He said, when he called me to preach, I told the Lord, I said, Lord, I can't go except unless you go with me. I go, but you got to go with me. I don't have a church, but a lot of I get a lot of opportunity to come to minister the word. But I'm gone. I got to go, y'all. Thank you, Lord, for his word. Thank God for grace.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. We thank you, Minister Dennis Allen, for bringing a fresh anointed word from on high. Man, you truly bless me, and I know the audience are blessed today to hear a word from on high, man. And hey, brother, you're welcome to come back again and again and again, because this platform here that God has given me is going to go as an outlet to be a blessing to people all over this country. And I want to be able to bring a fresh word with men of God and women of God to come forward and allow God to use them in a mighty way here at Bluff City.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Man, I thank you, brother. I thank you. God bless you, man. You and your family, keep me in your prayers, and I keep you guys in my prayers. And we're going to continue to move forward in this Bluff City. And like I say, we're going to go from the back of the line to the front, because God is raising us up to be a blessing and to heal, deliver, and set the captives free.
Yes,
God bless you. God bless you, my brother. God bless you, man. And thank you. And we shall come together again and do something mighty in the Lord. God bless you, man.
Thank you, brother. God bless you.
Thank everyone. Thank everyone for watching the Bluff City Bess Show. I'm your host, Samuel Bess. And again, Bluff City Bess will be here. This platform has changed, but I want you all to know that I love you. And again, peace.